He's a nightmare walking psychopath talking iced tea. What up, homie?
What's up, you guys? What's happening?
We good, baby. We good, man.
I'm chilling, just talking to y'all. What's good?
Good, man. People still address you as Finn on the streets when they see you, man.
Some people walk up and say Finn. You know, some people say OG. Some people say iceberg. Some people say what's up, player. It depends on what angle you're coming from, you know?
Well, let me tell you something. I watch Law and Order every week, and I love you on the show. Listen, Ice, when you're on the show, I know you have scripts, but sometimes I'm watching and I'm like, is he off script and doing his own thing? Are you able to do stuff like that on the show?
Not really. You know, that's NBC, so you on script. But what happens is when you've been on a show that long, they know your voice. So the writers can kind of write down the lane. Certain little slangs, they allow us to twist. I write the slang. I know what's happening at the time. But there's a couple of ad-libs that got in there. Because a lot of times what you do, you'll do the take. And then you just might ad-lib for the hell of it. And they might, oh, we like that. But pretty much that show, you're on script.
Ice-T, tell me if I'm saying this right. You're the longest African-American man on television?
Yeah, in a role, in a lead role. Yeah, I'm the longest running black actor. I think Ipesa, who was on the original Law and Order, she might be the longest running black actor or actress. I think she might have me, but on one continuous thing, yeah, we're going 21 years right now.
Wow.
On Law and Order.
That's strong, man.
Yeah, so that makes that show the longest running drama in history. And I'm playing the police. Imagine that. How the hell did this happen, man? What's going on in the world?
Yeah, you were the cop killer, man, so that's crazy. Hey, but speaking of going strong and long, man, how's Coco doing, man?
Life's perfect. I mean, I can't complain. I wish I could push a pause button and just hold everything in place, you dig? So, you know, Chanel just turned 3.
Aww.
You know, so I'm living that life, you know, but it's crazy. I'm over here having such a great life and dealing with all this different drama that's coming over every week, from dealing with Mrs. Singleton and dealing with Nipsey and all that. It's tragic. It just makes you love your loved ones that much more, man. Realize how fragile life is, you dig?
Have you had an opportunity to speak to John Singleton's family or go visit?
Not at all. I don't know John Singleton like that.
Okay.
I would only see John Singleton in traffic, and I'd be like, man, when you gonna put me in a movie? You know, stop playing, you know? And we would joke, and he'd laugh, you know, Ice, I got you this, that, and the third, but I don't know him that close, you know? It's terrible. I mean, regardless, it's terrible, you know, and life is fragile, man.
Hey, so you got this new project you're working on, host and executive producer of In Ice Cold Blood. Tell us about that.
In Ice Cold Blood is a true crime show, which is basically we document a crime and how it happened and how it played out. People are very familiar with it. My wife used to watch this show, or still does, on Oxygen called Snap. This
exactly.
is a show about women that kill their husbands, okay?
I watch it all the time.
So I always advise guys, if your wife or your girl watches this show, watch it with her. You know, like, just look over and check the temperature every now and then when she feels it's okay to pull your plug. You feel me?
Right.
So I had a podcast and I spoke on Snap, and the Oxygen people got at me and they said, you'd be perfect to host one of our shows. So I said, sure. So we created one just based off diabolical homicides, cold-blooded murders. The first season was a huge hit, and now we're on our second season. People love the show, and I tell people, you could come up with any so-called great idea. It doesn't mean people are going to like it. Fortunately, people like this show, and it has legs, and we're here again.
We're talking to Ice-T right now. Man, what's it like being a father to a 3-year-old and you at 61? What is that like, man? I know it has to be fun running out.
It's the best thing that ever happened to me, honestly.
Mm-hmm.
Muhammad Ali said, when a man has a child in the second half of his life, it resets his life.
Yeah.
And it did. I'm more healthy than I was at 45 now. I'm in shape. I'm eating right. Because you immediately say, I can't go nowhere.
Right.
You immediately say, I got to stay healthy. I got to be around here. I got to keep employed. I got to keep hustling. People say, Ice, why do you do so many things? I'm like, because I ain't never made enough money to stop.
Right.
I got to keep hustling. You know?
Have you guys thought about doing the reality television show again? I watched it all the time. I love you and Coco on it.
You know, reality is a slippery slope.
Mm-hmm.
And trying to entertain people with your life, it's not a good idea to do for a long period of time. Because what happens is you get it. You get Ice-T. You get us. You understand us. Then the producers want you to do things that are not normal to keep the attention of the crowd, which that's when you start to get stupid. Then the producer's like, let's put Ice in an alligator cage. I'm like, no. No. So I just said, you know, we did it. Y'all got it. Love us or hate us. Moving. And do something else.
Now, I heard you're back in the studios working on an album. Is that right?
Yeah, we're doing another Body Count album, which is my metal band. You know, Ice is doing everything. You know, I'm like making sandwiches over here. I got this on this plate, this on that plate. I'm SVU. I'm just enjoying life. The fun thing is everything I do is fun, so it's not like work.
Well, listen, this looks to be fun, man. Host, executive producer of In Ice Cold Blood. Check it out Mondays, 8, 7 Central, y'all. It is the one, the only Mr. Ice T.
Can I say one more thing before we go?
What's that, man?
Exclusive on Thursday night, Snoop Dogg is going to be on SVU.
I will
okay,
be watching.
That's a good look.
Thank you, babe.
Okay, all right, y'all take care. Thank you, man. Watch it Monday and Thursday. It's jumping off.
You got it, my man.
All right, peace.